Good morning, everybody. I'm sorry we're a little late getting going. I had the same gremlins as Alan. Spirit must be talking to us. Anyway, good morning, everybody, wherever you are. And for those in Japan who I know do watch us, konnichiwa. For Alan and others in Spain, hola, buenos dias. But whether you're watching us live or whether you're watching on catch up, welcome to today's Healing Minute from the virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary. I'm John, speaking to you today from Hillingdon. The sun is shining, the sky is blue, and we're still in West London and due to enter semi-lockdown tonight. I need to warn you that if you hear a loud noise, please ignore it as we're on the flight path of Northolt Airport. The music you're listening to is by Aeolia. The CD is entitled Angel Love and the track Celestial Sanctity. I really thank you for joining us today to send out the love and kindness that is represented by the Healing Minute. This session includes an opportunity for each of us to send healing not only to ourselves, because we all need to be boosted, but to the people and animals we know are in need. The reading I'm going to do today after the Healing Minute is a major extract from Ray Branch's memorial speech at Harry Edwards Memorial Service after he passed in 1977. And the finishing music, despite the gremlins, I'm going to try and play Elton John, otherwise known as Reginald Dwight, Healing Hands, which I failed the other week. I hope I've got a new thing and it will work. I'm going to put the music off as we begin to relax in preparation for the Healing Minute. Now, as we prepare for the Healing Minute, please close your eyes if it is safe to do so. In your mind, take yourself off to your own personal sanctuary, somewhere that you feel perfectly safe, totally at ease, and completely peaceful. Take a really deep breath in through your nose and inhale the healing energy and allow it to flow through your body from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. And as you breathe out through your mouth, let go of all the stresses and the dis-ease in daily life. As we begin to attune, I shall read Harry's words on this topic. We give thanks that we are gathered here today. We ask that this place is filled with love, light, friendship, and healing energies. Surround us in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness to allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As our own chakra opens, we visualize a column of pure white light filling our body. Then feel the balance and harmony within our body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of our feet and our base chakra. We feel our connection to the universal source of pure, unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. I'm now going to read the Harry Edwards prayer, and I'd like you to bear these words in mind because they are very much a part of the reading I shall do later. May I be thankful for all the blessings I already have. Grant me relief from pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me that I may be conscious of their presence and so receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Grant me confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. I pray that good guidance and right influencing will inspire all your peoples to be as brothers, one to the others, and the peace shall endure for all time. Amen. We ask now that all the people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends, and the people who have requested distant healing. May they be placed in the healing light and receive that which they're allowed to receive for their highest good. We shall now have a minute's silence and send out prayers across the world. Thank you. Our thanks and blessings for your help today and to our friends in spirit. I'm going to turn the picture back to Harry's hands for the reading. This is a cast taken of Harry's hands, which sits under normal circumstances in the Sanctuary Chapel at Burrows Lee. Firstly, a warning. The information I've gathered for this reading is from various sources and may well be flawed. And if there are any errors, I apologise and please let me know. Henry James Edwards passed to spirit on the 7th of December 1976, aged 83 years. His last public demonstration of healing was at the Royal Festival Hall in London. And as per his instructions, his body was taken from Burrows Lee and cremated, without a service, without presence of family or friends or flowers. Vincent Hill told me that Harry regarded the physical being as merely an overcoat for the soul, and the ashes from the cremation were never collected, just left for the crematorium to dispose of. Harry regarded himself simply the instrument of the spirit realm. Burrows Lee is the physical memorial to Harry Edwards and his great works for spirit and indeed humanity. He left letters for his family and said the worth of a life is in its contribution to the welfare of others, and this worth should live on in the happy memory that remains after the physical life is finished. I hope that this will be so to some extent with me. If this is so, it is my body that has made it possible. It has served me well, and I'm grateful to it. Now that I have left it, it is finished and of no value. He went on to say, funeral services were for bodies, not for people, and he had always disliked the mutilation of flowers in wreaths and other funereal decoration. He also asked for young trees to be planted as a memorial. On the 15th of January 1977, Ray Branch, in accompaniment with Joan, his wife, who were the nominated successors for Harry, conducted a memorial service in the recently enlarged Sanctuary Chapel. Ray said many things, and the full transcript is available in his biography. However, I'd like to spend a little time with you this morning and now read the major extracts taken from a recording that was made on the day. But before I do that, I'm going to change the picture so that we can look at a picture of Harry, or a painting rather, that is exhibited in the sanctuary, in the hall, or the hallway that leads. Gremlins, bless them. In the hallway that leads to the healing area. So these are Ray Branch's words, and I quote, "Last Sunday afternoon we had an earlier remembrance service here for all at Burrows Lee. For the staff and their husbands, there were over 80 people present, and I recall saying to them that one of the things I've been finding so difficult during the past month is in referring to Henry," that's what Ray called him, "in the past tense, saying he was instead of he is, he used to instead of he does, and so on. And as for calling our services remembrance or memorial services, such words seem so wrong somehow in connection with Henry. And yet, what other words can we use with our earthly limitations? Of course, Henry does not have to be remembered because he is here with us all the time. However, we have to be sensible about it and acknowledge that a very wonderful physical presence has left us. But in his place, we have an even more wonderful spiritual presence. But let us for a moment go back to the physical presence. What a superb presence it was. The Henry I like to visualise is Henry on the back of the order service, plump, supremely confident, impish, as Maurice Barbanel has described him, leaning forward with his hand outstretched, saying in effect, 'Come unto me, for I will give you healing and refresh your soul.' And with those wonderful, strong and quilted hands, he would soothe away pain, remould twisted limbs, and when patients came to him whose minds were shattered like the dropped jigsaw puzzle, it was Henry who would pick up the pieces, put them back into place again. And those patients would walk out of his sanctuary, feeling 10 feet tall, with a new self-respect and confidence, and with a happiness that they thought had gone forever. This was the magic of the man we are here to honour this afternoon. During these past weeks, thousands of tributes to Henry have poured into Burrows Lee, and I think every superlative and every descriptive adjective has been used to describe his wonderful character. And I can tell you that to have read some of those descriptions made one feel very humble indeed. But almost as those superlatives, there was one word which stood out above all others, a word which Barbie, how Maurice Barbanel was known, used in a radio interview he gave a day or so after Henry's passing, and a word he has again used here this afternoon. That word is charisma. I had a rough idea of what it meant, but I thought I would look it up in the dictionary, and I had to go to 3 dictionaries before I could find it. And even then, I could only find the word charism. Let me read the definition for you. Charism, a favour, specially vouchsafed by God, a grace, a talent. As we all know, Henry was no ordinary man. This is an expression which is so well worn. But I have to use it again this afternoon, because if ever it was so apt, it is this case. For Henry was larger than life itself. Everything he did was always on a grand scale. Even if he made a mistake, it was a colossal one. But he would always totally disarm everyone with that wonderful smile. I had often said to him that if he ever had been a film producer, he would have made Cecil B. DeMille's epics look like lantern slides. The only thing negative about him was that he suffered from negative buoyancy. He couldn't swim or float. I mentioned films just now. About 18 months ago, there was some very serious talk about a feature film being made of his life. I don't know whatever came of it, but if the idea is ever resurrected again, I can give them the title of it now. Not The Man Who Knew Too Much, but The Man Who Gave Too Much. Because he gave his very life to spiritual healing. For right up to the last 4 or 5 hours of his passing, he was signing letters to his patients. We talk about charisma. You know, ladies and gentlemen, no matter what the day was like outside, it could be black with thunder, the sleet could be pouring down, and it could be thick with fog. But I tell you that the moment the office door opened and he stood there, roaring out his customary, "Good morning," the whole of the place became flooded with the sunshine of his glorious personality. This was a presence that is possessed of men born into this world once every 400 to 500 years. It was Robert Browning who wrote, "God is in his heaven and all's right with the world." I will paraphrase that and say, Henry's in his office and all's right with the world. Talking of Robert Browning, Joan and I took the office staff to the Yvonne Arno Theatre in Guildford for our outing, the annual one, to see a wonderful musical called Robert and Elizabeth. Perhaps many of you have seen it. It was a love story, the story of the great love between the poet Robert Browning and Elizabeth Barrett, based on the story of the Barretts of Wimpole Street. Love letters that he wrote to her and she wrote to him were so wonderful, so moving, that they now become part of our literary heritage. You know, when we talk about love letters, we think perhaps of a small bundle of yellowing papers tied with a piece of ribbon and tucked away in the back of a drawer to be taken out and looked at in years to come. Well, I have now got a totally new concept of the meaning of love letters, because in the last 2 weeks following Henry's passing, we received here over 12,600 letters from all over the world, letters which I can only describe as love letters, letters from the thousands of patients and friends who wrote to us and the Edwards family in such moving tones at hearing of Henry's passing, that it was most humbling to read them. Time and time again we read this sort of thing. "I feel I have lost my dearest friend. It is as if I have lost my father. He was just like one of the family." One Sunday morning many years ago, at a time when I had not known Henry for all that long, I came round to Burrows Lee, and when I knocked at the office door, a voice boomed out, "Come in!" And when I entered, there was Henry, sitting there, which is in itself rather surprising, for he was never an early riser on Sunday. It was only about 10:30, but his first words to me were, "I knew you were coming round." I don't know how he knew this, for I had told no one of my intentions. However, we sat together talking for well over an hour, and there was one thing that he said I shall never forget. It was, "There's a lot of love in this work. It has taken his passing into spirit life to make me fully realise the magnitude of that statement. For never have I seen so much love as I have in those letters. All that love that he gave to his patients through his great healing gift can never be truly measured or assessed. And I doubt if any man since the time of Jesus Christ has been so dearly loved by so many people all over the world. Some misguided people, indeed they must be misguided, used to say that because Harry Edwards was a spiritualist, he could not have been a Christian. What nonsense. It's about as silly as one of the Sunday papers saying about him that is about after his passing, that Edwards, the silver-haired healer, with millions of admirers, always claimed he achieved miracle cures. Every one of us here this afternoon knows that Henry never claimed anything of the sort. But to return to the suggestion, he was not a Christian. He was the very essence of Christianity. He taught us an entirely new meaning of loving one's neighbour. He taught us to give ourselves in service to God. He taught us to face up to our problems and have courage for each day. Whenever he himself had problems, he always said to himself, "This will pass." And he taught others to adopt the same philosophy. He taught us the true values of life, taught us to look into a flower. Personally, I'd never looked into a flower until he told me to do so. But when I did, I realised what he meant. He even taught us to look upon a chair as a friend. Who else but Henry could even think of such a thing in relation to such mundane object as a chair? He taught us to have a song in our hearts. And above all, he taught us the real meaning of love in its widest sense. And to him, it meant giving of himself in the service of healing. There were, of course, times when there was very little love for him. For he was often, as we say today, eyeball to eyeball with the medical profession and the church. But he always stuck to his guns. An important thing was that they always respected him for his views. And if it were not for his fearless leadership, spiritual healing would not be on the unshakable pedestal where he placed it and where it enjoys worldwide respect today. His healing work will go on. It will go on in his special tradition, simple and unadorned, quietly and purposefully. Henry, for all his greatness and his magnificent presence, for all his foresight and knowledge, was a very simple and direct man. As the service ended, a recording tape was played of the Harry Edwards prayer, with Harry reciting it himself, which is why I said to you, pay attention to the Harry Edwards prayer earlier on. But Harry's final words from the tape at the memorial service were, "This is Harry Edwards saying, 'God bless you, my friends, and may all healing blessings be with you.'" That's enough of me wittering on. Now, let's look at parish notices. Tomorrow, we have our autumn fair. It's going to be online, on Zoom, and I guess Facebook Live. And there is a selection of presentations by various individuals on various topics, all of which you can read on the website. But it starts at 10:30 a.m. with our chairman, Martin, opening the proceedings. The Healing Minute tomorrow morning, which of course will be before that, is done by our delightful and lovely friend Doreen. And there is a Cygnus Cafe on Wednesday, undertaken by Wendy Lee, Inspired Wisdom of Uncertain Times is her topic. What am I going to do now? I'm going to say farewell and hope that my music works. You know that distant healing is available from the sanctuary, and contact healing, COVID secure fashion, is also available. So do call us, contact us. The tagline is, wherever you are, we're here for you. And it's so very, very true. And now I'm going to try and work against the gremlins and try and play some music that I wanted to play before. This is very special for my wife, my dear Sue. She adores this song, and I'm sure you will. On that note, I'm going to finish, say farewell. I'll be back again on the 30th of October, Friday, and my topic then is going to be the Great Invocation. What's behind it? What started it? What's it all about? And on that note, stay safe and healthy, and have a wonderful weekend.